Welcome to The Quiet Room, brought to you by the creator of Truth Well Told Tarot. Your space for relaxing music, meditation, and sleep enhancement. Join me on my new channel. I'll leave all the details below. The Quiet Room. Hello Taurus and welcome to Truth Well Told Tarot. This is Andrea and I'm here to do your May 2024 bonus reading for the sign of Taurus. Sun, Moon, Rising and Venus, so I hope you're well. As always, the reading won't be for everyone. Take what resonates for you. So welcome Taurus, let's see what we have for you as an additional message for May. Let's see what we have for Taurus, thank you. Three of Swords. Crossing that, we've got the Knight of Wands. Wow, above that, we've got the Sun. And we have the Two of Wands. Immediate past, we have the Ace of Swords. Immediate future, we have a King of Cups, can be male or female, generally heart-centered, connected to their emotions and feelings. Bottom two cards, the Five of Swords. And we have a King of Wands. Yeah, interesting bottom of the deck. It's the Queen of Pentacles, which is likely you. Let's see what we have for you as a spirit message. What do we have for Taurus? Thank you, angel, spirits, guides. Message for Taurus. Message for Taurus. We have reach out. We know you're reaching out right now for help. Due to a current situation, support is as much about the physical act of accepting help where offered as it is about the emotional benefits and learning that it's truly okay to accept support however it's presented to you. Bottom of the deck, we have let go. Once you let go of the outcome, you'll be able to release all the emotional constraints that have held you back in the past. Trust in the highest good and guidance of spirit, as we have only your best intentions at heart, and we'll do everything in our power to protect you. So we have reach out, let go, as energies from spirit. Let's see what we have as a money card. What do we have in money for Taurus? Could be additional messages that you need to hear. What do we have in terms of money, career, finances for Taurus for May? Two cards. Unexpected. Prepare for unexpected financial loss. This financial crisis may be out of your control, but you can still control the outcome. Deal with things head on and try to prepare for the unexpected before it happens. With that, we've got health. Some situation that needed resolution will be resolved and healed. Consider careers in the medical field, massage therapy, or any healing work. It's time to replenish your energy and fully energize to prepare for what's next. Could also be changes happening because it's healthy change for you, whether you see that or not at the time. Let's see what we have for you. As a romance angel card, what do we have for Taurus? Thank you. Yeah, finances and career. Financial issues are a factor in your love life right now. With that, Taurus, we have heart-to-heart conversations. Honestly discuss your feelings with each other. Let's talk about finances first, because there's just a strong sense of that here. Actually, I'm going to pull you one more oracle card. Message for Taurus. Thank you, angel spirits, guides. What else do we need to hear? So I've got stress, cleanse and detoxify from unnecessary commitments. That could also be financial, you know, especially with some of the financial messages coming out. You might be streamlining your finances in some way. What do I need and what don't I need, you know, in terms of how you spend your money. Bottom of the deck, I've got abundance, an inflow of money, love or rewards. So, I mean, that just seems very positive. Let's talk about money areas first here, Taurus. There is a kind of new path here with the Ace of Swords. It's about clarity, getting clarity, and it can be actually quite a successful energy, certainly in terms of money, career, finances. The Ace of Swords can actually be a sense of success and victory that marks a brand new path. Now, with the Three of Swords, sometimes we're disappointed to leave a place of work. We're disappointed to depart. I mean, I see that here. Sometimes it can be because, you know, you've gone through a painful experience also, and or painful, you know, news that you might have had, you know, whatever, again, that unexpected energy was. It might well be that you have taken action in a particular direction. I see some kind of new path being presented to you here, Taurus. And you've got a choice in terms of whether you accept it or not. And I feel this is to do with the Knight of Wands offers an opportunities for change. It feels very positive with that sun. The sun is good news, celebration, joy, happiness, light after dark. Also a very good clarity energy as well. It's a very positive energy. So it just feels, certainly with the Knight of Wands, this is the energy here where you just might be considering whether you stay or go in a situation. Do I step into the unknown? Do I take this new path? You've got a choice to make. I think that there is certainly an opportunity to walk a new path, but it means departing your current place of work. Now, this King of Cups is somebody who is generally connected to your heart, your emotions, your bond with this person. Even if it was a leader in business, this would be somebody who always has time for people, puts people first, always has their door open, just a very kind individual, always has time for people, invests in people, will do training programs and all of that kind of thing. If it was a leader, could also be your other half supporting you, could also be, again, a friend, a family member, you know, offering you some kind of support in some way. The Five of Swords, the King of Wands and the Queen of Pentacles, though. Queen of Pentacles is a really successful sign in terms of abundance. And it's kind of like, you know what's best for you. I think you're really kind of like being patient in making some kind of decision. But you're choosing to kind of like remove yourself from a situation, either because you want more, you want greater recognition and abundance. Or it could well be that you've gone through some kind of, you know, the environment that you're in, or you might not get on with your boss, or you might not particularly enjoy the team culture. This would be everybody in it for themselves, people doing whatever they want to do to get ahead. And it might well be that you've got some kind of decision here, Taurus. It feels like removing yourself from a situation here. King of Wands is likely somebody who is involved in the environment that you're removing yourself from. This is generally somebody who is action-orientated, go-getting, driven, charismatic, a leader, high energy. The downside of the King of Wands, it can be quite ego-based. So I think that you are, I mean, this is a very healing energy as well, health and healing, even making some healthy choices and decisions to remove yourself from a current place of work. And it feels like move towards this individual because you feel it's time. Whether there's stress as well, again, mental stress, again, with this kind of Five of Swords energy, people don't get on with each other. You know, it's always that sense of conflict energy. You know, going, people going and doing what they want to do and disregarding you, however that would be for you. But it feels like, I mean, the Queen of Pentacles, remember, male or female, is absolutely self-worth, self-value, you know, self-care, you know, and knows her self-worth, again, whether it's male or female. So I think that you are making some kind of choice or decision. I think a new path is opening up for you. You might have a heart-to-heart conversation with someone to say, do you think I should do this? Do you think I should go for this that's being presented to me now? You know, you might be reaching out to somebody. There's also a strong intuitive vibe in this energy as well. But either way, it looks like some kind of departure, because it is making some kind of healthy, positive changes for you, either in terms of also feeling abundant. This is a very successful money card, but also valued, appreciated, and really being in an environment where you feel that you can grow and feel stable and secure, and maybe not even having the mental stress, you know, or that sense of communication stress, you know, or conflict, whatever that scenario would be. So that's what I have for you, Taurus. I'm going to pull you an angel card. What do we have for Taurus? Thank you. Am I using these? I can't remember which angel cards I'm using. I think it's this one. No, I'm using these. Anyway, I'm going to use these anyway. Let's see what we have for you. What do we have for Taurus? Thank you. Curiosity. See life through the curious eyes of a child, and you will discover a never-ending source of happiness and excitement. Curiosity keeps you alive, interested, and interesting. The angels are inviting you to be curious about yourself, start exploring who you are, and you will grow personally and spiritually. Be interested in people, and you will discover an eternal source of fascination. Be curious about the wonderful universe in which you live, about the angels themselves and their role in the divine plan. The radiance of your delight in life will illuminate you. So the affirmation for the month of May, I explore the wonder of life. I think ultimately you're letting something go and moving to where you see growth and abundance, certainly in terms of money, career, finances. And I want to talk about love, romance, relationships, because I haven't touched on that. This could actually be some kind of three. I'm not seeing a third party situation, but I am seeing an ex. There would be an energy here, Taurus, in terms of somebody who has likely messed you around. I feel that they're likely getting back in contact with you. And I think that you have a choice or decision, because I think that you're already with somebody else. But I think that you are moving on the path that you feel is going to bring you happiness, joy, and growth and fulfillment. And that's where everything becomes clear for you in terms of making some kind of decision and choice. The King of Cups is likely here, somebody who is connected to your heart, who you bond with, who you feel that sense of you know, natural connection with. So again, there could well be some kind of heart-to-heart conversation on that basis here, but I definitely see some kind of ex presenting themselves to you as well, and that's the level of the unexpected that I'm seeing here, because I think somebody might be reaching out. I think that they will be asking you, even though they're kind of like quite an exciting character, even though they are quite an exciting person to be around, very confident, go-getting, likely successful, larger than life, and likely liked by a lot of people. They're likely to be very popular. I think deep down, you know who you want to put roots down with. And I think that through experience, you're wiser for it. I think you're looking at the facts of the situation. And it feels in this scenario here, Taurus, it feels like this person just brings conflict and drama. And you know deep down that they'll go and do what they want to do and sometimes disregard you, which is why it didn't work out in the first place. So it just feels like you're choosing to stay with the other person that you have already met, even though this other person is returning into your life. I feel that there is that kind of energy of some kind of ex returning. It may well put a degree of stress on your current relationship, but I think that you're very clear in terms of who you want to put roots down with. And again, this curiosity energy, it just feels that sense of, you know, been there and done that, you know, and I think that you're more curious about how you want to move forward. I think you know who you want to move forward with. And it looks like your current relationship, because this person just brings a degree of hurt and conflict with them. And I feel that there is an element of self-worth, self-value, a feeling of I'm not going down that route again. Sometimes can be a bit of a player energy as well. Non-committal, does what they want to do and disregards you. I mean, this is the whole energy here. Male or female with that, the Kings, but and the Queen of Pentacles. But the same message applies. I feel you're in truth in terms of who's right for you. And there's a lot of happiness. I think that when you make your choice, there's a lot of happiness. This is all about fulfillment as well. You know, moving in the direction of where you feel that sense of fulfillment in your treatment, in your experience with another individual is what I'm getting here. All right, final message for Taurus. Thank you, Angel Spirits Guides. Yeah, wisdom, you're wiser for it. We've got, have you ever been told that you're wise beyond your years? Now is the time to call upon your inner fairy wisdom to help you with the challenge. Taurus, that's what I have for you for the month of May as an additional message. I hope you enjoyed your reading. If you did, please do like, share and subscribe. I wish you a wonderful month. I will see you next time.